الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم.
الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. Before the Imam comes, just want to take advantage of this little time to explain to our moms and dads the last Juma, or last Friday, we were discussing about the etiquette of the masjid in order for us to make some necessary corrections so that we don't come and spend time in the masjid in vain. May Allah take that far away from us, because there's no better reward than you're rewarded for your effort and you're rewarded with the best of your interests. May Allah bless us with the best of our interests, inshallah. May Mama and Papa them, as I say, we come back again today for giving us a few advice of how we for the behave in the mosque, because sometimes when we come to the mosque, we can forget ourselves. We can make the experience of one and the same thing over and over. We can make with the camera the most forget blessing, but we end up forgetting with sin. May God forgive you for mistakes. I emphasized last week for say the mosque, my place of Allah, for respect everyone with the camera the mosque, and the mosque will not forget segregation. The mosque will not look down upon anyone because of your family member, or not to your race, or not to your tribe, or not to your country you come from. Islam is not like that. Islam is a unifying religion. Islam is a peaceful religion. Islam is a religion where there is respect for everyone. As I say, we got a verse of the Quran where Allah tells us, "Ya ayyuhan nas, O mankind, inna khalaqnakum min dhakari wal untha wa ja'alnakum shu'uban wa qabaila lita'arafu inna akramakum inda la yatqakum." That all mankind, Allah says, don't make you from a single soul of men and female. He don't make you from one man and one woman. After that, they make you into tribes and nations. Why? For we understand each other. Not for we come despise each other. Not for we cause confusion each other. Not for we try to practice tribalism, sectionalism, nationalism. But Allah says, the best of we that we get the taqwa, the fairness of Allah. And we as Muslims, we call the masjid. Now we can make sure we maximize the reward we forget Naya. Now all the Islamic brotherhood, the unity, the deen, now respect each and every one when they come to this masjid. So do not only keep place for somebody where your family, or your siblings, or your sister, or your cousin, and not come yet, but you take something, you put some for them that place. The people don't come early, they don't get opportunity for use the masjid. Then you don't come, you don't pray your first Juma, alhamdulillah, you don't get your baraka, then you prevent other people from not coming inside because you don't want to keep company. It's not fair. If they do it to you, you don't be happy. And this that is straightforward religion. So that's what Islam said. He said, do unto others what you like for them to do to you. So do. Now we could give the advice to them. Yeah. The advice here, not just for you to feel bad, but now for you think about it and not say that for your own benefit. Do. Let not the kind of the mosque, who the imam they come as the imam can, that the member who is in salam alaikum, will not be in talk, will not open other committee. You know, when they get a complaint, they are constantly sisters around, they pray for 10 days for advice. They can't be sisters there because they look out bad eye, they don't talk to them anymore. So, why not? Where's your deen? Where's your iman? They go show you for we are. So, we come there, so we polish yourself, we advise yourself because this is the deen of the sea and the deen of advice. So, we advise yourself for all come there, we come for kind of blessing, we don't come for kind of take sin. So, do, Lord, respect yourself for kind of masjid. Let us take ourselves as equals to the sight of Allah. Let Allah increase the world in the man. And let Allah make the world united in the gender. Because nothing more painful than when somebody don't walk, then you don't get a reward. May God Almighty must pay you for good work. Hallelujah. Anything that bad, may God Almighty must forgive you for that. Yeah? You will come at the masjid, as I said. The etiquette of the masjid and of Juma as well. Two upon us. Generally, if you get at the masjid, but when it comes to Juma, you get strict restrictions. Because you get a good 30 minutes when the imam begins sermon. We even we and you when they come inside, we get the habit of say for even greet when the imam starts. You don't say the Muslim get obligation when you say salam alaikum for letting apply you the equal or better. So when you come out of the masjid, you see the imam not start the sermon, please don't give salam. Please don't give salam. Not force the sisters and brothers for answer you salam.
So you follow when Allah forgive the salam. You don't come late at the masjid, you've already come late. And then you meet the imam and started the khutbah. So it, no one is obliged, no one is allowed to speak anymore. So when you come, keep your salam, please. If you wanted to give salam, come early. Because you are forcing them to give salam, to answer back to you. And it's not required, it's not good. So these are some of the etiquettes. When you enter the masjid, you do your sunnah, your two rakats of sunnah, before you sit down. But if you have sitting down, there's no point in getting up again when someone has started. That's a lot of misconception, a lot of bad practice. It is a sunnah that when you come to the masjid, you have to do two sunnah. Tayyat al-masjid. So if you met the imam and started the khutbah, you have the right to do the tayyat al-masjid. Do it and sit down instantly. But if you're sitting down already, and then you want to get up again to do it, it's not allowed. So these are the basic things we need to put in place, brothers and sisters. Let's respect each other. And then when you come, feel the safa. Don't allow the other brothers to come and see the gaps. And they're pushing you, taking your attention off the salah, off the khutbah. So do, when we come at the masjid, we make sure say we fill the space, all the gaps. Don't fill the gaps. As early we come, we fill the gaps. Don't allow, even the brothers, the way they marshal, they are not exempted. You know? Because sometimes we are out there as well, we go for the talk to yourself, we go, subhanAllah. We don't get to protect you. It's only 30 minutes. Sometimes you think you're doing good work, but you're not doing it the right way. That's a fitna. May Allah save us from this. Sometimes the circumstance, the situation, our behavior, attitude, putting those brothers in that situation. They have to talk to you. We have to force them to commit error. May Allah guide and protect us. If each and every one of us take responsibility of knowing what is required when you come to the masjid, you save a hell of a problem for them, from the brothers and sisters. They are making their efforts to organize the masjid. So if we are forcing them to commit errors because we are not taking, we are not adhering to what to do when you come to the masjid, subhanAllah, but I think about it. Please, so do you have your mama them, papa them? More especially with mama them, do this advice and follow we know for behavior in the masjid. You know, fine, after the Juma, they begin telling you, say, second Juma, they come. Do you want to give everyone a space? You've prayed. Go outside and give other people a chance. If you want to see the second khutbah, then sit down quietly. But if you feel say you don't pray other people another chance, give them a chance. Let me go and do the two Juma. So if you don't come and do the first one, the other one don't get a chance and do the second one. That's fair. But if they all come, you don't do the first one, then you don't allow the all come again for doing the second one because you want to go inside, you want to keep coming. SubhanAllah, don't fear Allah. We're not going to stop. We'll constantly remind you every Juma, inshallah. The Sheikh may come, inshallah, like I start the khutbah for you. Abana Sina Fiduni Hassana, Afila Khiyati Hassana, Akhina Adana Nan, Subhanallah, Rabbika, Abiyat Sabiyasifun, Salatu Salam, Nabi Salim.